Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this video, I will show you how to make a word-based design based on an animal's characteristics. For example, for a rhino, I use some words such as bold, audacious, undaunted, etc. For other animals, you could do a web search for animal characteristics and find many interesting ideas. I also created an African background for you to place your rhino in, if you desire. Load in the image. The link is in the description area. I have left it at the default size and resolution, but you may find it easier to reduce the size. Start out by cutting out an animal from an image. Try and get a good profile with most of the body parts showing. Here I have made a selection to cut rhino from the background. I pressed Alt-Control-J to copy the selection to a new layer and named it Rhino. Don't worry about grass or mud or other objects covering parts of the animal, as they will not be showing in the final resulting image. Make a new layer at the top of the layer stack and name it Reference. Make sure your foreground color is set to white. With the reference layer active, Control-click the Rhino layer thumbnail. Then stroke a 10-pixel outline onto the reference layer. Select a white hard round brush at size 15. Start laying out general areas where words might be placed. I tried to follow the contours and flow of the body. Try and avoid sharp angles. Remember, we can easily erase and redo any lines as we go forward. After filling in all the lines, here is the preliminary setup of the reference lines that I came up with. In choosing the segments, I considered that I might use Gutty in the belly area and the T in Intrepid for the ear and Focus for the horn. I also modified the outline a little to smooth out the angles. Control-click the new layer icon to place a new layer below the reference layer. Fill it in with a dark blue color of 0C2D4E. Press Alt Backspace to fill the layer. Add a new layer to the top of the stack. Name it Font Ref. Lock the reference layer. Go back to the Font Ref layer and change the foreground color to 91D5F5 for the word Dauntless. Zoom in some, then with a round hard brush, write Dauntless in the area you choose for that word. When done, start placing the other words with the colors you chose in the remaining word areas. This is not final, just an organized way of going forward. Here is the image after adding words and colors to the reference map. Ready to add words. Select the Font Ref layer and then reduce its opacity to 25%. Then lock the layer. Next, I'll show you two different ways of entering a word. Vary your fonts and colors to make the design interesting. Use bright, rich colors. I used Hobo Standard font with a color of 91D5F5 and a point size of 300. Type in the word, in this case, bold. Select the Transform tool, then stretch it with the side handles to about the width of the space available. Place it near, but not on top of its destination. Next, rasterize the type layer. Zoom in on the bold text. Now use the polygonal or rectangular selection tool to select the first letter. Once selected, Ctrl-T to change to the transform tool. Drag it to the approximate position. Hold down the Ctrl key while moving. You can turn it, enlarge it, or stretch it any way using the handles. Finally, if you still need more fitting, while it is still selected with the transform tool, right-click and select the warp tool and make your final adjustments. You can also use the distort, skew, or scale tool in each individual letter if desired. Follow the same procedure for the rest of the letters. Zoom out, select the O, Ctrl-T, shrink it, move it, stretch it, adjust it. Right-click and go to Warp Tool, fix the warp, Ctrl-D, highlight the L, Ctrl-T, shrink it, move it down, stretch it and adjust it. Right-click and go to the Warp Tool. Put it where you want it. Back to the D. Select it. Ctrl-T. Stretch it. Move it down. Adjust it. Stretch it, shrink it, go to the warp tool, and finalize where you're putting it. Control D. Next, I will show you the second method. This method works best when the shape being filled is similar to the options found in the warp dialog, such as arc or bulge. Zoom in to the general area. In this example, we will be entering gutty in the tummy area of the rhino. This area is roughly bulge-shaped. Make your foreground color 6EF396. The font Poplar Standard and the size 400. Enter the text over the gutty area. Center it as best you can. Rasterize the type. Press Ctrl plus T to choose the transform tool. Right-click and choose warp. Change the warp type in the transform options to bulge. Drag it with the mouse. Use the top handle to adjust it to its approximate position. Click the checkbox or press Enter to accept. Press Ctrl-T again to open up the transform tool. Right-click and choose warp. Continue adjusting the text to fit the area. When you're done, click the checkbox or enter to accept. Here is the image after I have added all the words in their proper places. It would be a good idea to save your work now. If you want to further enhance it, you can replace the dark blue background layer with any image you like. I have made an Africa background image for this picture. It should work nicely for most African animals. You can download it at my website, The link is in the description area. It is named Africa BG. Select all the word layers. Right-click and convert them to a smart object. Rename the smart object Rhino. To clean up, unlock the dark blue layer, layer 1. Then remove all the other layers below the Rhino layer. At this point, you can replace the dark blue background layer with any background you wish. To load the Africa BG image, or an image of your choice, select layer 1, then choose Place Embedded from the File menu. Then place the image. Rasterize the Rhino layer. In order to outline the Rhino better against the background, add a stroke layer effect to the Rhino layer. I used color 062B69. At 13 pixels size, blend mode of normal, position outside, and 95% opacity. At this point, you may notice some rogue brush spots. Use your eraser brush to remove them. Then, with the Rhino layer active, Control T to size and move the Rhino to an appropriate location. This concludes the video. Hope you can find ways to utilize this technique. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking the magic hat button. You will be informed of any new videos as they are published.